Hi, it's Brian from iSpring, and today I'm going to show you three really simple but effective PowerPoint features you can use to increase your productivity. The first thing is this thing up here called the Quick Access Toolbar. It's the row of buttons at the very top of the screen, and it can contain anything you want. I'd like to take a moment here to point out that these buttons are at the very edge with no border, so you can slam the mouse up there with 100% acceleration and not go off the edge of the button. This is a design feature that's always existed on Macs, but it took a while for Microsoft to catch on. This little drop-down menu right here contains some common commands that you might want to put up there, and you can enable them with checkboxes. If you want, you can move this toolbar below the ribbon, but then you would lose the advantage of being able to slam your mouse up there. For a full list of commands, click here. It starts out here with a list of popular commands, but in this drop-down you can list all commands and even macros, or see all the commands available on a certain tab. Even commands from add-ins like iSpring can be added. I could spend hours showing you all the cool stuff you can do with these, but as a rule of thumb, what I recommend you do is note to yourself what kinds of commands you use frequently. The whole idea of this toolbar is so you don't have to hop back and forth between tabs on the ribbon. So let's say you do a lot of font resizing, and you insert a lot of shapes. Every time you double-click a command, it's added to the toolbar. You can make this toolbar available for all your projects, or maybe just set up a special toolkit for a particular project. Now, as you can see, I have instant access to font size, and I can instantly draw any shape I want. Normally, those commands are available on the Home and Insert tabs, but no more hopping around for me. Now on to the next tip. A lot of times, you'll have objects regularly spaced on a slide like this, and in that case, you can use smart guides. See those red lines that appear when I snap to an alignment? Those are really handy and are actually activated by default, but there's other stuff you can use too, like regular guides. You can adjust these to certain levels so all shapes will snap to them. Grid lines are another way you can do that. And in this little pop-up window, you can set their spacing and choose whether or not to snap objects to the grid. Let's clear our grid and guides and see one other thing that's useful, the ruler. Those dotted red lines show you where your cursor is, so you can easily find the center of your slide and regular spacings. Finally, there's one more hot tip that will help you become more productive with any software, and that's keyboard shortcuts. Pretty much everybody knows copy, cut, and paste shortcuts, but you wouldn't believe some of the other cool shortcuts that are out there. For example, selecting text and hitting Shift F3 will cycle between different capitalizations. Holding Control and dragging an object away will duplicate it. F5 will start a slideshow, but Shift F5 will start it from the current slide. In fact, knowing those shortcuts can help you save space on your Quick Access Toolbar, so I can probably get rid of this slideshow button. Oh, and remember my Shapes button? Ready to have your mind blown? Alt-NSH. Boom! That's N for Insert, SH for Shapes. By the way, just pressing Alt will guide you through keyboard shortcuts for all these commands. I'm also going to include a link in the description to a list of PowerPoint shortcuts, and this is what I want you to do. Browse through the list, or at least look at these Alt guidelines, and then think to yourself, which of these operations do I perform on a regular basis? Start small. Commit a couple of shortcuts to memory, and then just start using them instead of clicking around. Alt-NT, I want a table, NP, I want a picture, NX, I want a text box, and V, I want a video. Pretty soon, you'll find yourself reaching over to the keyboard more and more often, and before you know it, your right and left hand will make a killer team. Well, I guess that's about all I have to share with you today. Can you think of any more cool PowerPoint productivity tricks? Let us know in the comments below. Did you like this video? Give it a like and subscribe to the iSpring YouTube channel for more updates.